overflow sexuality. Every time we turn on the TV or go outside in the world, we are exposing ourselves to things that God deems an enemy.
Right.
What do I mean by that? Because anything that gratifies your flesh is an enemy of God.
Right.
For God says carnality is a direct enemy of mine. Hallelujah. And I don't know about you, but I don't want to be an enemy of the Lord.
Yeah.
Why do we think and why do we act and why do we do some of the things that we do? Well, it's because you have exposed yourself to adultery. You have exposed yourself to fornication. You have exposed yourself to uncleanness. You have exposed yourself to lasciviousness. You have exposed yourself to idolatry. You have exposed yourself to witchcraft. You have exposed yourself to hatred. You have exposed yourself to bitterness. You have exposed yourself to emulation. You have exposed yourself to wrath. You have exposed yourself to strife. You have exposed yourself to seditions. You have exposed yourself to heresies, envies, murders, drunkenness, revelings. And the Bible says this, those that do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God. Come on in here, give God some prayer. Might as well pray that I'm not finished yet. Hallelujah. You have exposed yourself to the things that gratify your flesh, and now your flesh is on parade. That's why it's important that we must pray and fast to keep your flesh under subjection.
Why
do I keep doing things that I know I shouldn't do? Because your flesh is in control and your spirit is not. Hallelujah. 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 The Bible says those who do such things will not inherit the kingdom of heaven. Tell someone, you got to get away from that stuff. Now, I'm not calling the TV the devil, but the devil uses the TV. I'm not saying if you watch a show or go to the movie that you're going to hell. What I'm saying is that you have to have a balance in your life. See, most of us, if we were to be honest, we spend more time in the world and in front of the TV than we do in front of God. That's why it bothers me so much to hear people gripe and complain about the service took too long. Why we got to be at church so long? Well, you've been in the world of the devil all week. And you come to Bible study, some of you, for 1 hour. Then you come to church for 2 hours. That's 3 hours with God. And how many in the world? You do the math. Hallelujah. You are out of balance. And you ask yourself, why can't I get free from sin? Because you spend more time invested in your flesh than spending time walking with God. You might as well give God some praise. You got to make a shift, brother Lonnie. You said that in earlier. We got to shift the atmosphere. You got to make a shift. You can't keep doing the same thing that you've been doing and expecting to get different results. The dictionary says that is insanity. Come on in here, give God some praise. This flesh, we got a bad case of the can't help it. I can't help but do the wrong thing. I can't help but be mean and nasty. I can't help but gossip. I can't help but lie. I can't help but be rebellious. I can't help it because why? My flesh has gotten loose and I don't know how I'm going to get it back in control. Hallelujah. Let me tell you this. Left unbridled breeds anarchy. What are you saying, preach? I'm saying this. If you take people and put them on an island and remove rules, when they come back, you'll find a bunch of dead bodies. You have got to have a governing force in your life to keep you doing the right thing. Come on, hear your gossip words. Got a case of the can't help us. I can't help but to try to con you. Smoke this square. I can't help but to curse you out when you make me mad. Why do I do these things? Because I'm continuously sowing to my flesh and I'm not spending time sowing to the spirit.
Yeah.
Don't you know when you sow to the flesh, you reap carnality?
Yeah. Come on.
What do you mean by that? Well, let me tell you this. When it's talking about sowing, it's talking about investing. When you invest more time in your flesh, then you reap fleshly things. You reap fleshly desires. That's when you start getting those thoughts. You ever been riding in your car and something jumped in your head and you said, where in the hell did that come from? Well, then you answer the question. That's exactly where it came from. It came from the pit of hell. And why? Because the devil is using your flesh to control you. Not only is he using your flesh, he's using the flesh of the people around you to influence your situation. Come on, give God some praise. It's time for us to make a shift. We have got to start spending more time with God. Tell somebody it's not too late. Come on, don't get down on yourself now, because we all make mistakes. We all fall short. Nobody in here is perfect. But we are striving for perfection. And I'm here to tell you or to give you some tips on how to be a successful saint. The first thing you got to do is adjust. You got to spend more time with God than you do with this world. That's again, that's if you want to be successful. Now, if you're okay, keep going. If you want to keep bumping your head, if you want to keep doing the same thing that you've been doing, if you want to keep running your head into a brick wall, then you go right ahead. But for the ones who want to make a change in their life, and in the lives of their loved ones, and in the lives of their community, you have got to make a change. Now, I'm not saying you can't watch TV. I'm saying this. Be careful of the appetite that you feed. Why do I like Rocky movies? Why do I like sexual movies? Why do I like things that are contrary to the word? Well, I can tell you, because you were born in the iniquity. You were born into sin, and you were shaped in iniquity. That's why nobody ever taught you how to tell a lie. It comes natural, but you have got to be taught how to tell the truth. So what am I saying? That you are in this world, and you got to become a part of the world, but not in it. Well, let me tell you this. We are walking around in this world, but we don't have to walk around being of the world. What I mean by that is this, that the world says we are in a recession. Well, I'm not of that system. I'm of God's system. And God said he will supply all of my needs according to his riches and glory. So I'm not of the world system. I'm of God's system. And I got to make a shift in order for me to stay successful in God's system. Understand my own actions. I am baffled. I am bewildered. I am bamboozled. I do not practice or accomplish what I wish, but I do everything that I loathe, that I can't stand, that I hate. I find myself doing the very thing that I can't stand. Why is that? And even the things that I do go against my morality. Hallelujah. So what am I saying? I'm asking you this. Why do you do some of the things that are contrary to your own beliefs? Stop walking around here like a hypocrite. Hallelujah. Because you know you're not supposed to be out there shooting up. You're not supposed to be out there smoking. You're supposed to be a child of God. Now, if I do habitually, that means if I keep doing what is contrary to my desire, that means that I acknowledge and agree that the law is good. It's morally excellent. So the law that God puts out, it is good. But we find ourselves doing the thing that is contrary to the law. Hallelujah. Come on, give me some praise. I'm going to sleep on it now. He said, verse 17, he said, however, somebody say, however. It is no longer I who do the deed, but the sin which is at home, in me, and it has possession of me. Hallelujah. We've got some folks that are possessed. Hallelujah. You're possessed by sin. You're under the influence of not alcohol. You're under the influence of sin and the devil. Hallelujah. I feel my help coming. You've got to say hallelujah because I'm gone. Power to get out of that pain of sin. agency, superhuman power. This is the package that you get when you get the Holy Ghost. Power. I need power in my life. Glory to God.
Yes. Glory.
Hallelujah. Some things in the atmosphere. Some people are looking for change but don't know what change will come for them. Well, I'm here to tell you, it can happen to you too. You can't be forever changed. The question is, how bad do you want it? Do you want God so much that you're willing to push your plate back? That you're willing to turn off the TV? Cell phone and spend some intimate time with him.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Listen, so I hear this in my spirit. You have survived on someone else's prayers long enough. Some of us are only here because our grandmothers and mothers were some praying folks. But I'm here to tell you, it's time for you to stand on your own two spiritual feet. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Get some power of your own in your life. And some of you, I can see the pain that you're carrying. I can see the hurt that you're carrying. I can see some of us want to do the right thing, just like Paul said. But you can be free today. Hallelujah. And if you want a release on today, if you're looking for God to demonstrate his glory in your life,
then you
come down to this altar. Hallelujah. The altar is open for you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.